Are you generous enough to lend money to family or friends? Well, then you should watch this video about how to record that in your home finances. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If the condition is lending money to a family member or a friend, it means that you are not charging interest to this family member or friend, and you are not requiring identical monthly payments on time, every time, until the loan is paid off. If those two conditions are true, then it's more like a business loan than an informal loan. And if you have either of those two situations in your loan, then I suggest that you simply use the method in the video called QuickBooks for a Finance Company. And I have included that video at the end of this playlist. You see, this situation is much easier. All you have to do is create a current asset type of account, and you can even name it loan receivable to Mr. This One or so-and-so or whoever. Simply record the check or the payment to that person in the amount of the loan that you're giving, and then use the current asset account that you just created at the bottom of the check. It's that simple. For example, let's imagine on June 29th, we loaned our friend, Danny Deadbeat, $1,000 for a one-time emergency that was vague and could only be solved by you lending him money right now. Now, before we predict the results, I'm going to ask all of you in the audience to be a little patient with me and bear with us. You see, this video is an add-on addendum to the course because I didn't think that that many people loaned money to family and friends. So our example is before all of the advanced transactions that you might have recorded in the advanced section. So we want you to just watch quickly to get the idea because it really is amongst the most simple things that you would do in the course. So what will happen in the trial balance if you lend $1,000 to your good friend, Danny Deadbeat? Well, if the money came out of Chase Bank, then Chase Bank would decrease by $1,000 and become $1,000. And of course, the current asset that you would create, receivable from Danny, would show up for the first time in the trial balance as $1,000. And because we're advanced at this point, we can create the account at the moment that we write the check. Now, in the home finance course, we're using the registers. So for using the Chase register, we click here, and all we have to do is put the date, and the date was June 29th of 2016. And the amount that's coming out of our bank account is, and of course you can put all the other details that you like, but you don't necessarily, you can put Danny on the name of payees, add new. He's basically a customer because he owes you money. Click OK. But the most important is the account. You can scroll up and click Account New, and this will be Other Current Asset, Loan Receivable to Danny. Click Save and Close, and when you record the transaction, you can open up the trial balance and see the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Loan receivable to Danny is $1,000, and cash in bank went down to $1,000. Now, in this situation, Danny is allowed to pay what he can whenever he can. And when that happens, simply create a deposit for each payment he would make to pay off the loan. In the deposit window or in the register, use the same current asset account that you used to record the loan. For example, let's imagine on July 4th of 2016, Danny gave you $400 to pay off some of the loan. Now, what will happen in the trial balance? Well, if he gave you $400, that means the loan would decrease from $1,000 as its balance to $600 as its new balance, because he just paid off $400 of that loan. And because the $400 is deposited into the Chase Bank will increase and become $1,400. So we open up the Chase Bank register. We put in July 4th of 2016. And of course it came from Danny the deadbeat. And it's still loan receivable to Danny, but this time it's a deposit. It's a deposit into Chase Bank of $400, which means you can see the balance went up, but really you should open the trial balance and confirm that Chase Bank went up to $1,400 because the loan receivable to Danny went down to $600. And you could always double-click and show Danny every transaction regarding the loan. Hey, Danny, on June 29th, I gave you check number 6 for $1,000 from my Chase Bank, but then on July 4th, you gave me $400 that I put into my Chase Bank to lower the balance of the loan. So this is plenty enough if you lend money to a friend.